related to the spiritual world may seem complex, but once one gets the hang of it, stepping into this realm in meditation is as easy as walking through a door. Do you remember how many false starts and stumbles it takes for a child to learn to walk? But once it has been mastered, the playpen has to be put away. Walking into the inner world is not very different. One tries and waits and concentrates again and again. And suddenly one is there and knows that the experience can be found. In Christianity, this process begins with the realization that God broke through into human history. Because of the death and resurrection of Jesus, we know that His love is found in it. There is something worth the effort, and when an individual becomes ready and turns to this reality, usually because one is unable to manage by oneself, then our teaching, preaching, and training of children in the basic elements of Christianity are nearly fulfilled. Probably no one is educated into a vital and personal faith, but when the need arises, a person who already has some understanding of spiritual reality and knows where to turn for guidance spiritual direction is ahead of the game. We have already considered why it is important to stay in touch with the church, but there is so much misunderstanding about the psyche and the inner journey and what is found there, that a concentrated reminder is advisable. Let us look briefly at this process and then see how the sacraments and rituals of the church relate to it. the key that unlocks the door to the inner world is imagination. Most of us can allow images to arise from the unconscious that will tell us about our inner being and how it is affected by persons from the spiritual or psychoid world. One can even learn unknown things about the outer world in this way. But this kind of imagination does far more than simply provide information. Images give us a way of thinking that brings us closer to actual experiences of the spiritual world than any concept or merely verbal idea about that realm. The powers of the spiritual realm seldom deal with people just on a conscious, rational level. God, of course, can reach an individual by a rational conversion experience, but such an experience is only the beginning of a journey into deeper and deeper relationship with God. God seems to want the whole person and to be willing to work with our ego consciousness as though it were slender lifeline that would grow stronger with deeper inner experiences. When prayer and meditation concentrate only on concepts, they do not touch the most profound part of our being, except when it happens accidentally. Conceptual thought does not have the same power as the ability to think in images. We are so aware of the importance of logical, conceptual thinking. However,